This video is sponsored by Soundcore. What is going on, everyone? My name is Jason, and this is the iPhone 13 Pro Max 1 week later. Okay, so it's been a week with Apple's newest and most expensive new iPhone, the iPhone 13 Pro Max, and man, I have some thoughts. Now, I think the initial response to the new iPhone 13 lineup being rolled out a few weeks ago could be generally described as lackluster. And on the surface, I can understand why you might have been disappointed, as most of the changes and quote-unquote improvements can be deemed fairly iterative, or so it would seem. And look, I'm not going to try and convince you one way or the other. Personally, I feel as though Apple really worked on differentiating the iPhone 13 models from each other more than they have in the past, so it's hard to make such a generalization. But I've been using the 13 Pro Max variant for the past week now, and I can say confidently now that despite its eerily similar look to the 12 Pro Max, this iPhone is noticeably better in multiple ways. So today, I want to talk about how my experience has been with this very fancy, very expensive phone 1 week later, to ultimately help answer the question, is the iPhone 13 Pro Max worth it? Now before we jump into the review, in case you're new here, I'm Jason. I would really appreciate it if you give this video a thumbs up, it really does help me out. And in case you're a tech junkie like me, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you can stay up to date with all the reviews. And before I get into my thoughts, I have a very fun random question for you. If you had to choose between the two, which one would you go with? The iPhone 13 Pro Max or the iPhone 13 mini? Curious to see which one's more popular? Let me know what you guys are thinking in the comments down below. Okay, first let's talk about the iPhone 13 Pro Max's physical design. If you have any experience with last year's 12 Pro Max, it's gonna look and feel extremely familiar. Dimensionally, it's virtually identical to last year's model, with the only difference being that the 13 Pro Max is just a tad thicker. It continues to use Apple's relatively updated form factor with that completely flat frame that seamlessly connects both the front and back glass panels, while still boasting an IP68 dust and water resistance rating. This being the Pro model, you also get access to the more premium build materials, with the frame being made out of stainless steel, you get that nice ceramic shield protection on the display, and the back panel using the frosted glass as opposed to the glossy one. And despite it being the same from last year, the iPhone 13 Pro Max still looks and feels incredible. I especially love this graphite version, as it still has this luxurious sheen to it that still gives off a sense of sophisticated stealthiness. With the slightly darker finish on the frame, it really is representative of a top-end premium phone when it comes to overall build and design. The only real visible physical differences are going to be one, the notch is slightly smaller than previous models, nothing major and nothing I would say is really noticeable unless you're really looking for it, and the other difference is going to be in the camera hardware. Both the housing and the lenses are larger, but the layout is going to be the same as last year. Now there is one more difference here worth noting that you're not going to be able to see with your eyes, but you will notice once you get the phone in your hands, and that's the phone's weight. The 13 Pro Max is around 12 grams heavier than its predecessor, making this a pretty heavy phone. Now I say it's worth noting because, in my opinion, the Max variant of the iPhone with this recent design language has not been the most comfortable in the hand. Its dimensions makes it difficult to operate, mainly because the width of the phone paired with the sharp edges of the frame leads to more fatigue in the hand. And now with the added weight of the 13 Pro Max, it'll likely add to the potential for discomfort, and it really may not be the best fit for you if you have small hands. Now I recognize that this is just my opinion that you may or may not share, and it's in no way what I would consider a flaw in the phone's physical design, as I don't think the Max versions were ever made with one-handed comfort in mind, but it is something to keep in mind. Overall, the physical design of the iPhone 13 Pro Max is exemplary, as to be expected, and 1 week later, I still feel as though it's not the most comfortable device out there, but it's definitely one of the most premium. Now before I get into the next component of the iPhone 13 Pro Max, I want to give a big shout out to today's video sponsor, Soundcore. Soundcore has been leading the charge when it comes to affordable wireless headphones for the masses, and they were awesome enough to send out their latest pair, the much anticipated Soundcore Liberty 3 Pro. Now I'm just going to come out and say it, Soundcore continues to deliver what's in my opinion the best overall sound quality coming out of any pair of truly wireless headphones, a sentiment that is truly exemplified by the Liberty 3 Pro. I've had these in my ears non-stop since they sent these over, and I'm still blown away at just how good these sound. And one of the main reasons for that is that Soundcore equipped these headphones with their in-house ACAA 2.0 technology. It's their custom coaxial dual driver technology that is specifically calibrated to deliver both high and low frequency sounds directly into your ear without interference, giving users an immersive wide soundstage without the overall sound profile sounding flat. And this is some of the best bass I've heard on any truly wireless headphones, and it's pretty incredible that it's balanced out by very clear mids and highs without any component overpowering the other. They're fantastic for listening to all types of music, especially if you're into music that emphasizes the low end. And these have been just as enjoyable for something like a podcast, which really speaks to their versatility. Now, as this is part of Soundcore's Pro lineup, you definitely get a ton of Pro features, the main one being their Hear ID active noise cancellation, which not only automatically adjusts to the noise levels around you, but also specifically to your ears. In the Soundcore app, one of the first things you'll do when setting up the Liberty 3 Pro is something called Hear ID. It's basically a proprietary sound test that Soundcore administers to ultimately create a tailored sound profile based on your specific results to not only provide the best sound for your ears, but also the most optimized noise cancellation. And I was legit impressed with the ANC. It's really cool how the level of noise reduction changes based on the environment that you're in. And no lie, it makes the listening experience so much more immersive. The Liberty 3 Pro also have a great physical design. The drivers are easy to get into your ears and they stay there, even when being pretty active. The carrying case is compact and easy to take on the go. And they come in a variety of different colorways that all look great. These headphones pair wonderfully with the new iPhone 13 lineup. It's been so great for watching videos, playing games, and listening to music, and it's been my favorite accessory for the 13 Pro Max so far. If you guys want to learn more about the Soundcore Liberty 3 Pro, there's a link in the description that will provide more information on these fantastic headphones. Find out firsthand why these are such a hit. Check out Soundcore today. Now, there may not be many differences when it comes to physical design, but you start to see how the 13 Pro Max stands out when it comes to performance. First, Apple equipped this phone with their newest silicon, the ultra-powerful A15 Bionic, which Apple claims is the fastest chip ever on any smartphone, which gives the iPhone 13 Pro Max an immense amount of horsepower. Now, are you going to notice a significant increase in speed in your day-to-day use? Probably not. And that's mainly because iOS is already so optimized that the added power is not going to present itself in navigating around the OS faster. Most of the processing strength that you're afforded through this chip is actually leveraged by the advanced camera features, something that we're going to get into later in this review, but this is a great upgrade overall. You'll have no issues keeping apps open in the background for a long time, mobile gaming is an absolute walk in the park, and you're going to have an incredible lifespan on this phone if you plan on using it for a long time. Now, another area of performance where there's a change, and one that's likely going to be more noticeable when it comes to day-to-day use, is the battery life. Remember how I said the new 13 Pro Max is a tad thicker and noticeably heavier? That's because Apple equipped this phone with a beefier battery, and after a week of using this device, this upgrade is probably the most underrated and the most appreciated. Apple claims that it provides 2.5 hours more battery life than the 12 Pro Max, and research done by The Verge shows an 18.5% increase from last year. Now that's pretty amazing because the battery life on the 12 Pro Max was already pretty good, as you're able to get a comfortable amount of screen on time without needing to re-up in the middle of the day. The battery life on the 13 Pro Max is so good, in my week of testing, I didn't even get close to being red at the end of the day, even when I was pushing it pretty hard. And because the phone is so big, I think most people who opt for this model tend to leverage it more as their primary content consumption device. So it's pretty fantastic that it's equipped with a battery that will almost never give you charge anxiety, no matter how much you're using it. Now, it's only been a week, so I'm going to need some more long-term testing. But so far, the iPhone 13 Pro Max's battery life is one of the best out there right now. And I feel as though it's going to be an underappreciated feature until you actually start using the phone. Now, the next area of performance where you're likely going to see the biggest difference is in the display. The 13 Pro Max is still rocking a massive 6.7-inch Super Retina XDR OLED display that looks fantastic. Everything is tack sharp, you get really good contrast with those true blacks, and content consumption is extremely immersive with this large size. Now, where the 13 Pro Max's display really makes a leap in terms of engagement is in its updated refresh rate. Yes, Apple finally implemented their ProMotion display technology to their Pro iPhones, giving this device a 120Hz variable refresh rate, and man, it's pretty awesome. No doubt, Apple is extremely late to the high refresh rate party, but typical Apple here, when it shows up, it does it right. And this display is no exception. Now, full disclaimer, this is going to be really tough for me to get this point across, mainly because I'm saying it's the most noticeable and impactful difference you see on this device, but it's extremely difficult to show the difference on camera. But trust me on this one, the difference in user experience is pretty immediate. Scrolling through apps and just navigating around the UI is silky smooth, gameplay that take advantage of the high refresh rate are more engaging, and it makes what already is an extremely refined user experience even more polished. Now, a big challenge around high refresh rate displays is that it can lead to battery issues as they are pretty power demanding. Apple's ProMotion display has a variable refresh rate, which automatically scales and fluctuates between 10 and 120Hz based on what you're doing, And I'm happy to say that it's not one of those displays that throttles the high refresh rate, so you almost never get to experience it. The vast majority of the actions on the iPhone 13 Pro Max are buttery smooth, and you're still able to get phenomenal battery life. Again, I know it's really hard to distinguish any of this on camera, but this to me really is one of the most significant changes to make its way to any iPhone. Considering just how much you interact with your phone's display, it's going to be one of those upgrades that once you experience it, you're likely never going to be able to go back to the old. Okay, the last area of performance where the iPhone 13 Pro Max has made some changes is within their cameras. Let's start with the hardware first. The camera array of having three on the back, one primary wide angle, one ultra wide, and one telephoto zoom, and a front-facing selfie camera hasn't changed. What has changed is that all three cameras on the rear have larger sensors than before, and these allow the cameras to take in more data and more light, and man, the results are pretty outstanding. The iPhone has been delivering incredible still image quality for some time now, and though it's not a night and day difference between last year's model, there are some noticeable improvements. Visually, I think the biggest improvements are number one, you get a lot more detail than before, and this is some of the best low light performance I've seen on any phone, and Apple made some serious gains with the ultra wide camera. It's clearly sharper than before, which is great because I love this lens and I use it a lot. And one of the newest features to make its way to the ultra-wide lens is the ability to shoot in macro. And it can take some pretty impressive macro shots. Also, the telephoto lens got a bit of an upgrade as well, as it now has a full 3x zoom focal length as opposed to the 2.5, which is nice. And even though there's really no difference to the selfie camera, it still produces really great selfies and some of the best portrait mode shots you can get. Now when it comes to video, Apple continues to completely obliterate the competition, giving users the best video capability on any smartphone by a far margin. You can shoot your standard 4K video in either 24, 25, 30, or 60 frames per second, the most frame rate options I've seen on any mobile device. You can shoot in 4K Dolby Vision HDR at up to 60 frames per second, and though it's not officially out yet, you'll also be able to shoot 4K ProRes video at up to 30 frames per second. And as to be expected, the video quality you're able to get with this phone is extraordinary. Footage comes out razor sharp, you get bright, punchy, and accurate color reproduction, the stabilization is so good it looks like you're using a gimbal, and the dynamic range is almost like magic. Even the front-facing video crushes the competition out there, as it offers the same level of quality of the cameras on the back. And one of the new camera features that Apple is pushing hard on its launch of the iPhone 13 is something called Cinematic Mode. Now this is where it really leverages the monstrous strength of the A15 Bionic to artificially create some pretty cool looking depth of field tricks, like racking focus between two subjects, and kind of giving like a portrait mode for video. And honestly, the quality is pretty good. If you look closely, you can see how it's artificial, and that may not be the most appealing, but no doubt it's super impressive that the phone can handle this level of processing while filming live. Now most consumers probably don't have a need for it and will likely never use it. It could be useful for those who are using their phones for more professional video production, and given the increase in creators on platforms like TikTok and Instagram, it could be something that provides those users some unique value. At the end of the day, when looking at the cameras as a whole, I feel confident saying this. The iPhone 13 Pro Max will give users access to the best camera hardware and camera quality available today. And when you pair that with all the other great things about this luxurious phone, there's not much to say about it that's bad. Well, lest we forget the price. The iPhone 13 Pro Max starts at a wallet-crushing $1,099. And dude, that's a lot of money. Unless you're one of those folks that needs to have a massively large device, I would probably hold off on this one and go with a regular 13 Pro instead. You get the exact same features with the more comfortable form factor, and you'll save $100. But if you need that big boy screen, honestly, I don't think that you're going to regret this purchase at all because it's a pretty damn good phone. It's a premium user experience from start to finish, and despite looking familiar to what was launched last year, Apple did make some noteworthy upgrades internally that may make the iPhone 13 Pro Max one of the best Apple devices ever made. But it's only been a week, so take that sentiment with a big grain of salt, and let me know what you guys think of the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Do you think it's worth that max price tag? Let me know what you guys are thinking in the comments down below. Okay, that's about it for this review. Don't forget to leave me a thumbs up if you guys found it useful. Again, I'd really appreciate it. Check out these other reviews if you're looking for more. And I'll see you guys in the next one.